And you see where he sits now in the Yankee rookie double leaders list. He's got 2 days to try and surpass Joe DiMaggio, but that's got to look pretty sweet for him right now.
And for a guy who started the year in the minor leagues to be on that graphic in that position with Joe DiMaggio is pretty incredible. And we showed, some, you know, during the game, it didn't look like Andujar was really locked in at the plate, shaking his head a little bit at some pitches that he was missing. Even when he doesn't look like he's 100% there, he finds a way to drive the baseball. He's such a dangerous hitter, covers so many zones, so many speeds, just a tough guy to game plan against.
It's a constant narrative we've had, especially in the last 2-3 weeks, American League Rookie of the Year. Looks like he's really jumped ahead of Gleyber Torres, as good as Gleyber's had. And if it's between he and Shohei Ohtani, you know, even Ohtani's numbers are down a little bit compared to Andujar.
Yeah, you look at Andujar and what he has meant for the Yankees all season and the kind of things he is doing that simply haven't been done. To put your name right next to Joe DiMaggio, we've also talked about only 4 Yankee rookies with 25 homers and 90-plus runs batted in. And I think there has to be something within that award for doing it for the entire season. Now, we mentioned Brandon Drury started out as the third baseman on opening day, but he was gone within about a week, and suddenly Andujar was thrust into that position and never gave it back. That wasn't his job when he was given it. It was Drury's job to take eventually. Andujar never let that happen. He's my pick for Rookie of the Year. I know Ohtani is a great candidate, but I would go with the guy who did it all year long, did it consistently, and did it for a team that had very meaningful games to play.